guys, welcome to this pre-build video in The Sims 4. My name is Irene and today I am building my Ravine Villa. As you could see in the intro, this house has a lot of different layers, different heights, and is built above a ravine. Every once in a while, I love doing these builds that look interesting top-down, like my cracked earth underground house or my sunken jungle I did a couple of weeks ago. They always feel like puzzle builds to me because I have to puzzle around a lot and I love doing that in the game. But these two examples I was just talking about were both underground, and I thought it would be fun to make something above ground with that same principle, so that it looks cool from the top down and but still above ground. So I started thinking what I could do with that. I really wanted to do something that was high up in the air. I thought maybe I could do something on a mountain, but then I realized that it could be kind of cool to make it across a ravine. So that's what you can see here today. It will have a lot of different layers, a lot of luxury as well, because this house will have a pool and a gorgeous bathroom and of course a lot of other stuff. And yet, normally I always talk about what my inspiration was for a build, or I show you a picture on screen. Well, not today, because I didn't really have a inspiration picture for this build. Like I said, I just really wanted to do something that looked interesting from above, but not on the ground. Yes, you know what I mean. So as you can see here, I already started by raising up the ground and with that very regular shape here. Always when you want to do a house on a mountain or on a cliff or on a ravine in this case, you can go two ways. You can build the house first and the mountain or the rock or the cliff or whatever underneath it later on. But you can build the house or the mountain first as well. You can raise up the ground first as well and then build the house on top of it. It totally depends on the type of build you're going through. I've talked about this before, but if you really know what kind of shape the house is going to be, then I recommend you to start with the shape of the house first and build the mountain or the cliff later on underneath it. But in this case, like I said, I didn't have an inspiration picture or something like that. I had an idea in my mind, but not a clear picture. In this case, it was easier to raise up the ground first and after that to build the house over it. Because I wanted to make this house or this ravine, the sides of the ravine especially, as high as I possibly could to go for that extreme effect. So I raised up the ground as high as I possibly could. As you can see here, you cannot raise up ground any higher than what you can see right here. And unfortunately, you cannot really build higher as well. Yeah, of course you can build these four levels higher, but normally when you're building on the ground, you can raise up your builds or your rooms with that foundation tool. Well, this is kind of the maximum height. When you build something just on the ground, on a raised up ground here, you cannot raise it up with the foundation tool any higher. So this is really the maximum height in the game. Quite sad actually. It would be amazing if you could build really, really high builds with more levels, more possibilities. Oh, well, maybe that's coming in the future for The Sims 5. Well, before we get The Sims 5, I'm sorry, a little bit off topic. I read yesterday that next Tuesday, so exactly a week from now, a new expansion pack is going to be announced, and I'm so curious what it will be. Of course, I don't know what it will be. Oh, I'm so curious. And the last new pack for The Sims, that Star Wars game pack, got so many backlash and so many negative criticism and response. And I really hope that they will make an expansion pack this time that will fit the taste of a lot of other people, of a wider range of people. I know you can never please everybody, but I think there are especially a lot of people who want a pack that can fit they're just normal gameplay. So I'm very curious what we will get. Normally, before we got that Star Wars pack and that Eco pack, I always wanted to have a futuristic pack or a space pack. But yeah, now we got that Star Wars pack, of course, and yeah, I don't think we will get a space pack or a futuristic pack now or in the future or soon. I think, to be honest, in a year from now, The Sims 5 will be announced. So yeah, I'm so curious. I'm actually happy with everything now. I love new content. Of course, I always love doing these more on the futuristic, spacey side of builds. But I did that Birdcage, that steampunk Birdcage, a couple of weeks as well. That wasn't futuristic at all, and I enjoyed myself so much with this one. So I'm just happy with new content. And I really hope they will make something that will please more people. So I'm so curious. Just a week from now, I cannot wait. But let's go back to the build. As you can see, I just made a water in the middle of the ravine. I always do that when I'm building canyons or ravines like this. Because of course, in nature, these ravines or canyons are made because water has run through the mountains, a natural process. So I always love building water inside my canyons or ravines as well. Do you know what the literal difference is between canyons and ravines? And to be totally honest, I don't know. I think canyons are very, very long, like the Grand Canyon. Of course, you have smaller canyons as well, but they are more long. And I think ravines are a little bit smaller. In this case, I thought ravine villa sounded more interesting than canyon house, so that's why I picked ravine this time. But if you know the real difference between it, please let me know. But yeah, I made that water. I placed the water emitters, these fog smoky emitters in the water. So if you go to live mode, the water looks more realistic. But when you zoom out a lot, that effect disappears. So while I was building this, every once in a while you see that effect disappear. And when I zoom in more, you see it appear again. Of course, I wanted to cover up these edges with rocks and with plants and everything. I didn't really talk about the entire shape of the house. I just experimented with shapes and with different shape decks and with different heights. And I experimented with roofs, and especially later on, you can see that when I'm placing in all the different colors, you can see it here. I wanted to do something with the grass roof types we got with the Eco Lifestyle pack. I never really did something with that before, and I know this build isn't an Earthship, but I had the Earthship thing in my mind. It's totally different than an Earthship, I know, because it's not in the ground, it is above the ground. I still wanted to do something with grass all over it, so that's why I picked that color first. And like I said, with the entire shape of the house, I just experimented with different shapes and with different rooms on different heights. And in that way, this whole process, just this whole house just took its shape in that way. But I was talking about the rocks that I used on the outside of this ravine. I'm placing in trees right now. The rocks that I used, you can see them very good right here. They're debug rocks. And I always talk about the double cheat you have to use to unlock these items. I talked a little bit more about it during my previous video. But under my previous video, there was actually very interesting comments. Someone said, explained to me that you only have to use one actually to enter the debug items. I always said you have to use the bb.show objects and bb.show live edit objects, but you only have to use the bb.show live edit objects cheat to unlock the debug items. I didn't really try it out yet, but I believe you when you say something under my video. So yeah, I think it's correct. But you have to use the cheats to unlock these debug items. And the rocks that I used, I made a blend between the new rocks, these softer green rocks. They came with the Star Wars Journey to Batuu pack. And black and green rocks, and they came with the Island Living pack. I wanted to make it look very green, and maybe you've noticed it already, but I started this build in Windenburg, the world that came and get together, and I switched to El Salvadorada. I always forget that name. Yeah, I think it's El Salvadorada or El Salvadora, whatever, the world that came with the Jungle Adventure Pack. I started this on just that 64x64 lot in Windenburg because I didn't really know which nature side, world side I wanted to go. I just wanted to start building and let the build evolve, and I just wanted to see where I would end up on. And when I was picking out the rocks for the sides of the entire ravine, yeah, I realized these rocks I picked, I was just talking about these Island Living and Star Wars Journey to Batuu rocks, were more beautiful in a very green environment. And especially because I wanted to cover them up with a lot of plants as well, I thought it was a little bit more fitting to place it in this world. It was quite a while ago that I did a build here. Every once in a while when I do a build, I just switch from lot to lot to lot, and sometimes I load in a build over here on this lot as well, but then later on I will switch back to another one. But now I will stay here. The light is perfect for builds like this over here as well, because in the beginning of this video I was talking about that I wanted to make this house look cool from above. And of course, I always want my lots with good lighting. I always want a lot with light from the front, because you can see better what I'm doing. It's better for the intros and thumbnails and for the entire video and everything. But on this particular lot, the light comes straight from above during the day. So that is perfect for a build that I wanted to make interesting top down. But the entire color scheme of the house is already ready, and the ravine and all the plants and everything. I made a decision to keep it quite empty in the middle of the ravine, because I will place in a little bit more flowers later on. And this walking bridge, of course, and it will have several levels. And yeah, I experimented a lot with that. I cut that out of the video, but in the end I ended up with these different levels. Of course, I had to make an entrance for this house because I wanted to make it functional. I will put it up on the gallery so you can use it in your own game. I do have some problems with the gallery though. So annoying, but my previous build, the Las Vegas cinema that looked like a Las Vegas casino, isn't showing up on the gallery. It's so strange. Same for the birdcage. But yeah, it's so strange. I uploaded it twice or three times again already, and I don't know what is happening, but I really hope this one will show up good on the gallery. I didn't really have these problems before, so I think everything will be okay. But I will put it up on the gallery so you can download it and put it in your own game. As I said, I used that Jungle Adventure lot, but if you don't have that lot, of course you can use this build in other lots as well, in other worlds, as far as you have a couple of expansion packs, because just the base game doesn't come with a 64x64 lot. But Windenburg has one, and that is Get Together, of course. City Living has one, but it's it's in the middle of a city, so I think a house like this would be very strange in the middle of a city. But we're already onto the interior, but I make these walking bridges in the middle of the ravine to make it look even higher or more complex from above, because you have these walking bridges as well. But we're onto the interior now, and I wanted to go for a jungle theme in the interior, but keep it very modern as well. So I went for kind of a green color scheme with very dark wood as well. And the most important packs for the interior, yet again, Eco Lifestyle. I love using that pack for the build and buy items, but a lot of Island Living, a lot of Jungle Adventure as well. And the lights that I used here, these hanging lights, are from the Bowling Stuff pack. And I never had that bowling stuff pack. I realized that I was still missing two packs in my game. That pack that nobody wants, that my first stuff pack... Stuff pet? Whatever. My first pet stuff pack. Yeah, that's the correct term, I think. Or correct... whatever. But I still don't have that one because I checked all the items that you get when you buy the pack. Well, I wasn't that interested, but I still didn't have that bowling stuff pack as well. And there was a sale last week, so I bought a bowling pack and especially these lights, these hanging lights. Man, they're so cool. So I used them a couple of times throughout during this build, throughout this interior as well. And some bar stools later on too. These wall decorations, as you can see right here, these panels, these wooden panels are from the Eco Lifestyle pack. But yes, I combined a lot of packs together yet again. I always use so many packs in my builds. But the only exception is when I do a base game build, then I really only use the base game. And it was a long time ago that I did a pure base game build. So I promise you, in the near future, I will do a pure base game build again. Because I think doing base game builds, just pure base game builds, are always so kind of challenging and refreshing to do. Because I always tend to use kind of the same... furniture or interior. It always looks a little bit different though, but when I do a base game build, I suddenly realize how many cool items there are amongst the base game items as well. We're onto the kitchen right now, and these wall paneling, these wall decoration, as you can see over here, these beams are from the Eco Lifestyle pack, and here are my favorite kitchen cabinets. Talking about items I always use in my builds, I love them. They're my favorite kitchen cabinets in the entire game. Or counters, I'm not sure what the correct term for them is. But they came with the Island Living pack, and I just love that waterfall edge on the side. Oh, I love it. But I really want new kitchen counters in the game. I really want new kitchen counters because these are very, very modern, and we have a couple of other modern ones as well. But we have so many bars in the game. Why don't we have more kitchen counters? Yes, I want more. And of course, you can make your own custom-made kitchen counters. You can combine counters together, but they have to be the same color at top, so it doesn't work that perfectly. So I really hope with that next pack that's going to be announced next week that we get new kitchen counters as well. I'm very curious what you want for a new pack though. They announced already a couple of weeks ago that it doesn't come, that it will not come with farming, with cars, with new improved babies and with bunk beds. So yeah, I know a lot of people want a farm pack. I know it's not going to be a farm pack, but what do you want for a new pack? Please let me know. In this kitchen, you can see these bar stools on the kitchen island. They came with the bowling stuff pack as well. And a dining table over here, and these dining chairs came with the bowling stuff pack too. And yeah, of course, that pack is already quite old, but always when I have a new pack, I love using the items that came with that new, with that new pack for me. So that's why I used it a couple of times in this build. Over here is one of the bridges in this entire house. This one is above the ravine, obviously. I wanted to make it a little bit more light, a little bit more lively or something. So I used these small outdoor lights. Here is a very small bathroom with two showers and a sink. It's more the bathroom where you go when you're swimming in that pool. And there are actually two other pools in this house as well. There's three in total, but these other two are more decorative. This one is the functional pool, if you will. And of course, you have that massive water feature on the bottom of the ravine as well. You can go there, you can swim there. But if you have a pool like this, of course, it's easier to just swim over there. Over here, I had a little bit of space left, these smaller rooms. This is one of the levels, though. Above this level is way more space with a big bathroom. Of course, you can see that in a couple of minutes. But I wanted to... This house is quite big where you see it from the top, but there wasn't that much space in the interior. Of course, had enough space for a big bedroom, a big kitchen, a big living room, but I wanted to use every single spot of space that I got. So I made a decision to make a fitness area over there on the other layer, and we're now on one layer higher. And here is the meditation room with, I think, a yoga mat. No, I placed lounge chairs on the deck outside. But of course, if you have that spa day pack, you can easily replace it with a yoga mat. I thought it would be kind of zen to live high up in the air in over here and to do your meditation here in the middle of nature. So that's why I decided to make it over there. Over here is the bedroom. This is my favorite house in the favorite room in the entire house, is what I wanted to say. These plants that you can see on the wall, they came with the Eco Lifestyle Pack as well. And they're so cool, but in some kind of way, I never really used them before. It's a little bit sad that they only have one pattern. It would be amazing if they had different patterns that you could place next to each other to really make it into a wall. Now you just have that repetitive pattern, but still, I love it. I think it looks so cool. But because these panels had a repetitive pattern, I placed that bamboo in front of it. I thought it broke that pattern a little bit. Over here is an area with a desk in a couple of seconds. These flowers on the wall, I use them on the exterior too a couple of times. On the deck outside, they are so gorgeous as well. Never used them before as well. They came with Eco Lifestyle too. As you can see, I just talked about that this house is quite big but doesn't have that much space in the interior. Well, this bedroom is gigantic, of course, and the bathroom that you can see in a couple of seconds as well. So it's very, very big, but when you look at it from the top, it looks massive. Well, it's not massive, but it's still quite big. Over here is a bar. Like I said, I wanted to make it like a luxurious house with a lot of things to do. So that's why I made that fitness room and a meditation room, and that's the pool. So I wanted to make a bar over here as well. I thought it would be fun to place it next to the pool in that way. Over here is the bathroom with this very luxurious bath, of course. And I made my own shower over here with this waterfall accents and with that shower that came with the Discover University pack. That amazing one that is perfect for if you want to make your own custom-made showers. But yeah, this is the last room already. Of course, in the end of this video, you can see the cinematic outro or house tour, whatever you want to call it. I'm very curious what you thought about this build. Please let me know. If you have some requests for me, please let me know that as well. Thank you guys so much for your support. I really, really appreciate it. I always love reading your comments. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please do. It would make me so, so happy. I will be back next Friday with my next video. I really hope to talk to you then. Have an amazing day. Goodbye.